Warning, European traders, Privateer FX coming at you with a little European opening call here. We got this dollar yen here, just printed a triple top, 109.79, prior highs were 77 and 75. Because we're non-farms today, we're not going to chase this and play around with this. It'll be interesting to see if this 79 print holds, and maybe later in the day it comes into play. Interesting on how dollar yen keeps charging higher. This, of course, surely has a lot to do with the rates. 10 years on its knees today. 278, almost 279 in the 10-year yield. So this is quite interesting from a yield perspective and the bond market perspective. We're definitely in this sort of bear mode in the bond market. These higher dollar rates are not really helping the euro. A lot of that has to do with the fact that bunds are also getting crushed. Boons now 158.16, they closed yesterday. Anyway, we printed a 22 high last night. Yesterday's high was 22, last night's was 15. Of course, the high of the year was 38. Again, this is just a setup worth watching for non-farms. Nothing to do here this morning. Are we going to create a little double top up here, or are we going to charge through? This is going to have a lot to do with how we respond to the number. 180 is expected. Everyone's looking at the average hourly earnings, and we're in that usual binary situation. Just to the antipodean currencies. You know, we got short Kiwi last night up in the 90s, back down here at 63, not bad. We're just going to grab the cash here. I don't really understand what's going on in general. Should be a lot lower with yields where they are, but Kiwi held, did not break these interesting 74.20 highs. And even more interesting, the 74.40 highs. If you look on the daily, you see how these tails here are now lower highs. We expect this to turn lower. I don't know what the delay is, but we're core short. We're looking at core short Kiwi. We're square again now. CAD, kind of the same situation. We're looking at this 122.50 and saying, this looks like a very important low and could be a range low. Again, it's going to be tough because we got non-farms today. We're not going to go into non-farms with a position, but this does look like a range low to us, 122.50, so we expect dollar CAD to edge higher over the coming days. Aussie, same deal. This has been more collaborative. It's offered. We had a nice low yesterday at 79.87. This should continue to go lower. But again, if you're not short yet, you kind of have to just sit on the sidelines and wait for non-farms later today. Let's go to cryptos. They got crushed. Now's the time to put up or shut up. 8,400 was given. We are also sitting at 7,400 and 6,400. We'll be looking to trade out of this probably over this weekend. We're expecting more downside today. If you look at the headlines around the world, Bitcoin, people are in panic mode again. What happened to the $44 billion in market cap? Yada, yada, yada. We've seen these type of moves before. And there's usually a 30 or 40% bounce. The strategy remains the same. Stay calm. Collect your longs here. Be patient. Trade out of your longs on the bounce. Leave a core short. Because what we're really hoping for is, you know, is to have your core short in this sort of 2,500 to 4,500 range. And then just sit. Ethereum, same trade. A little bit slower on the downside. We've got 777 here, which should be a good little buy area. And then maybe, why not 666 just for fun? And maybe 555 for fun. And then just be patient. Your stop loss on this stuff is zero. So use the capital. Use capital that you can afford to lose. Don't bet the ranch on this stuff. This is what we call never sell. It's a little bit upside down on risk reward as far as the way we tactically trade FX, but it's a bit of a different animal here, and we're looking at a different philosophy. So proceed cautiously, but proceed with fun. And if you believe in it, get right in there. We definitely believe in it, and we are in it in the Bitcoin. We obviously love Nimic, as you all know, and we're in this for the long haul. As far as elsewhere in FX, our intrepid Aussie yen printed 50 again. If we do get risk off and dollar yen does turn, it could. This Aussie downdraft should help push this Aussie yen further lower. Boy, it's been slow going on the Aussie yen, but we still like this thing lower. Probably add through 50 and then finally through 22. Our long lost neckline from this quadruple top up here. Aussie yen, something to watch. Although, to be fair, on a non-farms day, we're focusing more on dollar-based pairs than crosses. Not much else to say on the European Open today. We're going to have a quiet morning, do some reading, relax a bit, and start visualizing what we're going to do for this non-farm afternoon. Good luck to you guys out there, and I'll see you at the New York Open. Ciao.